Good evening, my name is Engineer Piyush Pandey. Welcome to today's session of Motivational Skills, and the topic for today's discussion is lose your job but not your skill. Ladies and gentlemen, there are basically three methods by which you can lose your job. The number one is contract expired and you were out of the organization. You were working in an organization for a contract period, and when that contract expired, you are no longer the part of that organization, and that is a very genuine mode of leaving a particular company. Second case, you got a better job opportunity in some other organization and you resigned from your current organization. This is the second case. And the third case is someone played politics against you and you were out of the organization. I would like to repeat these three points, very crucial, ladies and gentlemen. Number one is you were hired on contractual basis. The contract expired and all those employees who were hired on contractual basis, they are no longer in that company. Second point, you got a better job opportunity with a better salary, with a better designation somewhere else, and you left the organization. Both these criteria are genuine criteria. But the third one is something different. Some internal employee of the organization, he played politics against you, and that's why you are out of the organization. And it is also a very common scenario in corporate world, ladies and gentlemen. Someone played politics against you, and because of that, you were fired. Someone was so intelligent, so sharp, so clever, that he convinced the management that you are a non-genuine employee of the organization. Ladies and gentlemen, in my previous videos also, I have emphasized this crucial point. And again, I am emphasizing this crucial point because this has become a norm nowadays in modern corporate environment. And not only in corporate environment, but in any kind of job environment, whatever may be your source of income, someone is always there who wants that your character gets assassinated in front of management. Your reputation is gone in front of higher authorities. And this third criteria of leaving a job is very disrespectful, ladies and gentlemen. It is very disrespectful. Someone played politics against you, you don't know who that person is, but because of the politics that he played, you are out of the organization. And when a person plays politics to throw somebody out of the organization, the only thing that he does is character assassination of that person. Character assassination of a genuine employee is done so that management feels that the person is really non-genuine, and management forces him out of the organization. And when a person is thrown out of the organization, believe me, ladies and gentlemen, he is not only out of that organization, he cannot apply in the same organization throughout his life. This is the criteria of every job scenario, every kind of company, wherever you are working. When you get fired, saying that you are not a man of character, or you are having a blot on your character, in that case, you can never become the part of that organization again. Ladies and gentlemen, if a person has done something wrong himself and then he gets fired from an organization, he himself knows that what he has done. He has a guilt in his heart that yes, I genuinely did wrong for the organization. And whatever I am getting in return, I truly deserve it. Whatever I am getting in return, I truly deserve it because I cheated my organization. And since I did it willingly, whatever I am getting in return, I deserve it. Since I did it willingly, whatever I am getting in return, it is really genuine. And next time I will be highly careful about this. But if the person has not done anything, if the person has been working genuinely inside an organization since the last 1 year or 2 years, and then he gets defamed without any fault of his, and then when the organization fires him, it is a moral setback for that person, ladies and gentlemen. It is not only a job loss, it is a moral setback for that person. And when that, on the day when that person gets fired, from that day till coming many months, that person is not able to come out of this shock that he received in his life. This shock is absolutely unbearable. I worked honestly and sincerely for this organization since last many years. I did my everything, whatever I could, to take care about the reputation of the organization. I did everything possible on my behalf to ensure that the reputation of organization only grows and grows. And still I am getting such kind of treatment in return. Ladies and gentlemen, a dedicated employee of the organization can never tolerate this thing. It is absolutely unbearable and it is a mental setback, because when employees work inside the organization, they not only work for financial gains, they have some emotional attachment towards the task that they do. They have some emotional attachment towards the people with whom they are working. They have emotional attachment towards the organization where they are working. It is not only a source of income for them. There is some emotional attachment between the organization and the employee. And the person who is genuinely working for the organization, who is very honest, highly honest, his level of emotion is even more deep as compared to rest of the employees of the organization. And if such a person is defamed and he is told to leave the organization without any fault of his, just because someone in a hidden way is playing politics against that person, that employee, ladies and gentlemen, it is a huge setback for that person. And that person will never be able to trust anyone in his life, because the setback that he received in the form of getting fired from the organization, even when he did nothing wrong himself, just because someone is defaming him and that person is hidden in some way. Ladies and gentlemen, if a person gets fired in this manner, it is absolutely unbearable. I must repeat this thing, ladies and gentlemen. You leave an organization because you are getting some other better job opportunity, that is fine. The project of the company is over and the company is no longer willing to extend its employees to other projects. The company itself wants to throw the employees out. That is also a genuine case, ladies and gentlemen, no problem. In that case, organizations give a proper experience letter to their employees. It is a respectful departure from the organization. Okay, the project is over. You may please leave. We are highly thankful that you were the part of this project. And we are highly thankful that you gave your precious time and effort to the organization. This is a reputed way of leaving the organization. But the third thing which I am telling you, ladies and gentlemen, it is highly unbearable, unacceptable, doing politics against genuine employees of the organization. Ladies and gentlemen, if politics is done against genuine employees of the organization, very soon that office, that organization will be full of only non-genuine employees who are totally involved in digging the grave of the organization itself. That's why, ladies and gentlemen, as owners of the organization, we must try to identify properly that who is working for the organization and who is working against the organization under disguise. That's all for today, ladies and gentlemen. I hope that you learned my today's video. Please subscribe my channel, ER Piyush Pandey, Trainer Meeting MBA, and please press the bell icon for constant updates. Thank you very much. Have a great day.